फ्रेंड्स, आई एम मिस्टर पी पी मित्रगोत्री, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग एट वालचंद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी सोलापुर। इन दिस सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अ डिजाइन ऑफ अ ड्राइंग डाई फॉर अ गिवन कंपोनेंट पार्ट टू। इन अर्लियर स्टेज we have already studied part 1 of design of drawing die, and in that we have come up to decision of number of draws. Learning outcome for this session also will be students will be able to design a proper die set for a given component. As already stated in earlier session of this, we have calculated number of draws required is equal to 2. So now in this session we will study the next procedure. Now, as we have decided to draw a cup in two draws, now we will start with first draw. Now, as already stated, not more than 45% reduction is possible in first draw. We will presume that 45% reduction is possible in first draw. Therefore, we will have calculation of diameter of cup after first draw and height of cup for first draw. Therefore, 0.45 is equal to 113 minus d1 divided by 113, where d1 is diameter of cup after first draw and h1 is height of cup after first draw. Now, from first formula written, we can calculate d1 as 62.15. Now, by constancy of volume relationship, h1 d1 is equal to hd, where h1 is height of cup after first draw, and h and d are height and diameter of cup in second draw. Therefore, h1 into 62.15 is equal to 45 into 50. Therefore, height of cup after first draw is 36.20 mm. Now, percent, we have to calculate percentage reduction required in second draw. For that, percentage reduction, to calculate percentage reduction in second required in second draw, we have to use the formula d1 minus d divided by d1 is into 100, where d1 is diameter of cup after first draw, d is the diameter of cup after second draw. Therefore, which will be 62.15 minus 50 divided by 62.15 into 100, which is equal to 19.5%. As this percentage reduction required in second draw is less than 30%, it is confirmed that cup can be drawn in two draws only. Now we have to decide the radius and punch and die set in first draw. For first draw, punch radius at shoulder is equal to 4 into sheet thickness, that is 4 into 1 mm, that is equal to 4 mm, as a sheet thickness is 1 mm. Die radius is also equal to 4 into sheet thickness, that is 4 mm. So die and punch radius for first draw is 4 mm. Radius of punch and die for second draw has to be calculated, but punch radius, that is corner radius of the cup, is given as 1.6 mm in the drawing, so that is fixed. Die radius R dash is 4 into sheet thickness, that is again 4 mm. Now, clearance calculation for die in the first draw. Now die clearance in the first draw is 1.08 to 1.1 mm into sheet thickness. Let it be 1.08 into sheet thickness. Therefore, die clearance in the first draw will be 1.08 into 1, that is 1.08 mm. Now die clearance for second draw is given by the formula 1.09 into 1.12 into sheet thickness TS. Let it be 1.1 mm into sheet thickness. Therefore, it will be 1.1 into 1, that is sheet thickness is equal to 1.10 mm. Now I will pose a question before you before moving forward. Why clearance is required to be provided during drawing operation? Think over it. Now we have to decide sizes of punch and die for second draw. Now punch diameter for second draw is diameter of cup minus 2 into sheet thickness. Why this is so? Because punch has to be smaller than the cup diameter. That is 50 minus 2 into 1, that is 48.0 mm. Die opening for second draw has to be punch size plus 2 into clearance. 48 plus 2 into 1.10, that is 50.20 mm, shall be the die opening. Please remember that punch size is smaller and die size has to be larger than our cup size. Then sizes of the punch and die for first draw. Similarly, punch diameter for first draw is D1 minus 2 into sheet thickness. 62.15 is the diameter of cup in the first draw, minus 2 into sheet thickness 1 mm, that is 60.15. Die opening for the first draw has to be punch size plus 2 into clearance, that is 60.15 plus 2 into 1.08 will be equal to 62.16 will be the size of the die. Then press capacity calculation. Total force is equal to drawing force plus black holding force. Drawing force has to be calculated by the formula pi into diameter of cup into thickness of the sheet into yield strength into bracket d by d minus c, where c is constant and value of c is 0.7. therefore, drawing force has to be pi into 50 into 1 mm thickness into 540 into bracket 113 divided by 550 in minus 0.7 is equal to 132.25 kilonewton. Blank holding force is generally 1/3 of drawing force. 1/3 of 132.25 newton kilonewton comes out to be 43.64 kilonewton. Therefore, total drawing force is 132 drawing force plus blank holding force, that is 132.25 kilonewton plus 43.64 kilonewton is equal to 175.9 kilonewton, that is equal to 176 kilonewton is equal to 17.6 tons is equal to 18 ton. Assuming required factor of safety, our press capacity has to be 20 tons. Now we will discuss the results at our glance. First draw, second draw, and quantity, that is diameter of punch, 60.15. Second draw, 48 mm. Die opening, 62.16, 50.20. Sorry, 64.35, 31, 50.20. Cup diameter, 62.15 and 50 mm. Cup height, 36.20. 45. Percentage reduction in the first draw 45%, second draw 19%. Blank diameter 113 mm, draw ratio 0.9, press capacity 20 tran. For further reading in this regard, I will recommend a textbook of production engineering by P.C. Sharma, tool design by Donaldson, press tool design by Indo-German Tool Room, Aurangabad. Thank you.